Last week, I assembled my PRUSA 3D printer and calibrated it for my first project. Hey there, I'm Tim Ung, and today I'll show you how I design and 3D print a custom planter that'll hold my mini cactuses. To design this project, I start by looking at the size and shapes of the cactuses and sketching an idea for the overall form of the planter. I love how all of the needles on the cactuses start at one point and actually expand towards the others. I decided to incorporate this aspect into the design of the planter by creating a shape with a series of points along the perimeter where the angles of the lines would change. I copied this shape 1 inch vertically and rotated it to stagger the locations of the points. I repeated this until I had a 5-inch tall planter. After offsetting the lines to give the planter thickness, I lofted the layers to create surfaces for the 3D model. Once the surfaces were created for the exterior and interior walls of the planter, I capped them and extracted the resulting shape to get a hollow planter. Then, I capped the base of the planter and included 4 holes for drainage. The catch tray's design matched the angles of the base of the planter and included walls to hold back any liquid. After I finished the 3D model, I refined the design several times and included several raised areas to hold the planter higher than the surface of the tray. Once I brought the model into PRUSA's slicing software, it was honestly the first time I ever set up a print. The total print time for the preset that I chose came out to about 1 day and 3 hours of printing. That didn't seem logical to me, so I decided to test a setting that a friend told me about called vase mode. It cut the print time down to roughly 6 hours, but it removed all the thickness I designed into the walls of the planter. I was willing to trade the 27 hours of printing for my original design with the 6 hours for this setting. I'm also curious to see how stable and functional the planter will come out with this setting where the walls of the entire planter will only be 1 layer thick. With the file in hand, I loaded up my PRUSA printer with a beautiful galaxy silver filament and began my first print ever. Once the print was complete, I let my PRUSA cool down and removed the print with the steel sheet and slightly bent the sheet downwards to release the planter. The planter looks amazing, but I'll need to be careful with it because the walls are very thin. From this first print, I already have ideas for how I could design future planters to be more rigid when printing with vase mode. With the steel sheet cleaned and ready to go, I placed it onto my PRUSA's heating bed and began the process of printing the drainage plate for the planter. Now that both pieces are printed, I placed the planter onto the drainage plate so I could carefully transport it around my house by holding it by the plate. Now, it's time to place some stones and soil into the planter so that I can transplant the cactuses. I start by adding a layer of stones at the bottom of the planter. For the next layer, I add soil and bring it to a height where the cactuses will be above the rim of the planter. I bring the cactuses to my table where I could watch their growth every day. I water the cactuses to help them adjust to their new home. Now, I need to figure out what to design next. Help me out by commenting below with your suggestion. If you enjoyed this video and want to support my channel, you can do so by subscribing, liking, and sharing this video with a friend. I'm Tim Ng, and I look forward to seeing you again next week.